Welcome to Perfect Word Media. My name is J. Period Monroe Johnson. And today is December 25th, 2023. And what we have is a sheriff, two bankers, and a lying lawyer all hiding because they conspired to steal a disabled elderly widow's life savings. They're caught. That's Jimmy Carnes, the prosecuting attorney for Albertville City. He was her corporate attorney. And he lied to sabotage a bank loan. And then he lied to the state bar. They then lie about lying. I mean, these people, they belong in federal prison, and we're doing everything in our power to put them there. It was December 2018 that the conspiracy, the takedown, was executed against my family. Now, this is by Marshall County officials, and this is after they got stopped in the Supreme Court of Alabama in case number 10517 726, Federal Credit Inc. versus Greg Fuller, that was released April 15th, 2011, that detailed how the city and county conspired to steal $5 million then. You've got Spectrum Charter cable executives providing less than honest testimony in a $5 million extortion scheme that rendered an illegal jury tampered verdict. And then you have Albertville City Judge D. Walker signing two illegal arrest warrants against me when the Supreme Court ruling was released. It was all dismissed, but that's how they do it. You know, our friend who recently passed away, Lynn Martin, that was also attacked by Marshall County. He was falsely arrested and charged with cattle rustling when he didn't even own cattle. And it cost him his job as the principal for the middle school in Douglas, Alabama. He signed and filled out about a 5-page affidavit as to how Keith Wilson of Marshall County, he's a county investigator, had a personal vendetta, and he took it out on him by false arrest, false accusations, which cost him his job. It's cruelty, it's ignorance, and these people belong in federal prison. That's Ed Kellett, the assistant district attorney for Marshall County. He allowed a illegal zero restitution in a $40,000 first degree theft to stand as the truth when he knew it wasn't. That was signed by Circuit Court Judge Timothy Francis Riley, who is about to retire. Good riddance. The man's dishonest, unethical, incompetent. Google the phrase noethics.org. And then his name, Timothy Francis Riley, a.k.a. Timmy, and a legal law review essay was written about his incompetence and his unethical nature. He thinks he's smarter than the Supreme Court of the United States and the Alabama Supreme Court, according to the legal law review article on noethics.com regarding Timothy Francis Riley. These judges, they break the law and claim qualified immunity. They were exposed in a $5 million extortion scheme, and now they've played a direct and or indirect role in ordering and or condoning a $1 million prime commercial real property theft. They did it by trying to force the property into foreclosure. They wanted to do it by creating a foreclosure that the county would then process. The sheriff wanted to serve foreclosure papers on an elderly disabled widow after he created the foreclosure. He bragged that he would pay his personal political debts with her stolen property. That's the real Phil Sims. His son was arrested on methamphetamine charges within weeks of him being elected, is what we were told. And we were also told that he's an alcoholic. Now, the second part is hearsay. The methamphetamine charges against his son are confirmed. That was in Coleman County. But regardless, he's power drunk. He's an alcoholic on power. Buffoonery. Not qualified. And he paired up with Margaret Lacey, the vice president of Cadence Bank. She's not qualified. She has a high school diploma from Memphis, Tennessee. And when our million-dollar property's mortgage was paid down to $40,000, she and he conspire to put me in jail unlawfully. And when that didn't work, sabotage the business. And when that didn't work, we are asking you to contact your federal representatives. This is a civil rights crime by the sheriff of Marshall County, violating the civil rights, the property rights, the dignity rights, the human rights, and the very life rights of innocent American civilians, myself included. We've lived in Marshall County for 24 years, not even so much as a speeding ticket. But the judges, who were evidently, according to Brother Chapel, very jealous, green with envy. He said it was jealousy that led to acts of insanity. Most people agree it's just greed. Greed overtakes everything, but jealousy leads to greed. You know, coveting your neighbor's possessions. These people don't miss a Sunday prayer service, folks. Radical religious zealots. They believe women are to submit to men. It's white male, white supremacist. And never forget what I said about the term white supremacy. If you put a hyphen between the two words, it becomes one word. White implies purity. They're nasty. Nasty is not just dirty, mentally, physically, financially, spiritually. It's a spiteful, contemptuous person, and that's what they are. They don't know how to lose, and they lost. And they lost real big. Boom! Did you notice that went off right on cue? I mean, you can't make this stuff up. I guess it was fireworks. But anyway, folks, they lost big time, and that's in the Supreme Court, and they don't call it Supreme for nothing. White supremacists, they call them white and they call them supreme. They call themselves that. Supreme implies better than all the rest. The Supreme Court of Alabama is truly supreme. And they ruled unanimously that the on-its-face $5 million frivolous lawsuit should have never gone to a jury for factual review. It should have never stood as the truth. It was designed to discredit us from ever being licensed with the FDIC as a money services business. They audited us. Every dollar was counted to determine our net worth. The state of Alabama, state banking department, they audited us. They determined our net worth was $5 to $6 million, and then they executed a $5 million extortion scheme against us. It took the Supreme Court of Alabama to stop the crooked county of Marshall from executing their crime, and they claimed qualified immunity. And again, they denied us statutory immunity. All we had done is cashed an attorney's son's checks that bounced. They were returned from Regions Bank and stamped closed account. We then sued for $1,300 to collect on the three bad checks, and they countersued for $5 million and said he was embarrassed at work because the 10-day certified bad check notice went to his work. He provided the work address and signed an application. And he signed the application an inch and a half high, with the date an inch and a half high. Folks, he came in there to steal $5 million, knowing the county was backing him. He was a fall guy, a pawn, a do boy. So he claimed that he was embarrassed at work and that we damaged his life for $5 million and the county backed him. Crooked county. Crooked father, who was an attorney, Dale Fuller. He later lost his law license because he stole another client's escrow money in the amount of about $65,000. He did that gambling. He lost his client's money gambling it away. That's Marshall County for you folks. And they want to be in charge. These white male, white supremacists. We ask that you vote humans of the female gender into powers of authority throughout Marshall County for the next 100 years. These white male, white supremacists, they're dangerous. One older gentleman said, military grade stupid. Well, you can say that when you're off. Vietnam vet, and he was. That's his assessment. They commit crimes, folks. Theft, just follow the money. It's just theft. They're thieves. Thievery is their nature, and they try to justify it with the Bible. You know, that women are to submit to men. God wants them to have her money. They're on a mission from God. God told me you're unworthy and he wants me to have your property. You know, that dangerous religious dogma, spiritual nonsense. And like I said, they don't miss a Sunday prayer service. It's radical, bastardized, Christianized fascism. They support an authoritarian style government. They want to be little Hitlers, whereby they rob people of their rights and their lives. They're just thieves and they advocate violence. What's extraordinary is these are the lawyers and the judges and the chiropractors and the sheriff and the bankers of Marshall County, Alabama, USA. Like, share, and subscribe. Pray for us. We pray for you. And just know, every word we say is true. We do speak in illustrations, in scenarios, in parables, in metaphors. But they all speak to a higher truth. They targeted us, folks. The white male, white supremacist, so-called. And again, they're not white as in pure. They are nasty, nasty people. And they're not superior of anything. That's better than all the rest. They're the worst of the worst. They advocate violence. They think they're above the law. Put these people in federal prison. Like, share, and subscribe. Pray for us. We pray for you. I'll close it with Gimme Shelter by the Rolling Stones. Mick Jagger wrote that. I was told as a teenager, he was about 24 when it was published in 1969. But, and those were round figures, you'll have to look that up yourself if you're interested. It speaks to what humans do to each other, and rape is more than just sexual. And we've been raped emotionally, financially, socially, occupationally, because Marshall County wants to steal our life savings. That's the sheriff. Believe me, it's true. Crooked County, put them in prison. Thank you. Oh.